Okay. Hi, and welcome to. What part are we on to? Can't quite remember. But yeah, what were we up to since then and now this part? Well, you may have noticed I've joined a new free company, or guild if you want to call it that. Hence why I've got a different name next to my character's name, which is U2B. I'm not really sure what it's supposed to mean. I don't know what U2B is, but because it's not my FC, it's my friends. Because I did create my own, which was a Doctor Who free company. But I created that like ages ago, possibly last year. But I never had the motivation to like run it. So my friend decided that he would go back to the game and decided to create his own, which is fair enough. I mean, my Doctor Who one was dead. I had lost motivation to run it. So yeah, I'm now in a new free company. Called Underground Crimsons. So yeah, if you're on my server, feel free to join. Anyway, I don't remember what we were doing story-wise, which is probably more interesting. think we fought Sin or Bismarck, because we needed the key to get to Ass's Lair, but the bishop decided to run off with it, which is typical. So yeah, I think that's as far as we got, if I remember correctly. Anyway, let's see what Tatru has to say. Oh yeah, in the live stream. We found. Oh, what the hell is she called? The one that wears a pink top. She was in a live stream, so yeah. One of our old companions. We haven't found the rest yet. Anyway, let's see what Tatru has to say. Ystola. That's the name, Ystola. Just seeing her face again. It's. Oh, I've been so worried. Tatru's surprise. Tatru needs you to fetch a few items for a crafting endeavor. And yeah, I've actually read up on like the main quest, how many I've got. It's just kind of like interesting to like know how many you've got. Like, but anyway, yeah. I've got about 17 quests left until the end of this quest line. But apparently we've got patch 3.1 coming out soon, and that's going to give us a whole load more story quests. So I really need to catch up. Ystola is resting within an inn room. Though she's still unconscious, the signs are positive. The conjurers say she is in sound health and should awaken before long. Isn't that wonderful? Now, while we wait for Ystola to wake up, I thought I'd take the opportunity to finish my little surprise for her. It's something I've been working on for a while now, in the hope that she'd one day return to us. It wants for just a couple more items before it's ready. I've already placed orders for these items. Could I ask you to retrieve them for me? One is with the Leatherworkers Guild, and another is with the Conjurers Guild. Speak with Mistress Jiva and Brother Isumi Yan, and they ought to take care of you. Okay, the first task for the day. Let's go to the leather workers first, I think. And yes, I'm playing as my monk. I'm not sure whether I'll change back to summoner or not. My monk is almost level 60, which is the max level. Yeah. So the way things are going, my monk might be the first of my classes to reach max level. And I can do some unsynced dungeons. Perhaps get things I couldn't complete last time completed. Where am I going? Reminds me, I need to store some crap in this company chest now that we've changed guilds. So, like, all my stuff that used to belong in my Doctor Who guild can go in here now. May as well, why not? So yeah, just bear with me a sec, people. I don't know if anyone ever needs this crap, but just in case. It's good for crafting some of these, like the black alumen. That's quite good. I did that quite a lot of times, leveling up my other crafts. But yeah, like I said, this is my friend, Sefsi. It was kind of a shame getting rid of my Doctor Who FC because, like, it was almost reached max level, which I think is 8. But, like I said, I had no motivation. I mean, my friend was also leader of it, but I'm not sure he liked me. I don't think he's a fan of Doctor Who, so it's fine. That was just a name that I picked out randomly. I'm more than happy to lose it. Just wanna get a good FC running, I guess. Almost a full page of stuff. But yeah, this is just what I had in my old FC. I'm not sure if we can have other items and stuff. Maybe my guild, my friend will want rid of some of his items, which is fine. He wants to discard some of it. Mithril ore. Might hang on to the mithril ore. But who can put the paint in? Oh my god. I do not remember having this amount of items. Okay, I'll have to do, I guess. I mean, who the hell uses potions anyway, so I might just sell them to the shop. All the rest can go to the shop. So yeah, I'll sell them to the shop. And we got a full page! But I believe once you've like, start leveling your free company, you get more slots for items. So at the minute we've got one items, which... like, you know, it's basically full now. Sorry. But yeah, as the FC gets higher in level, that one will change to 2 items and you'll have a whole load more boxes to fill with different items. So yeah, we just need to level it. Right, we were... actually, hold on. Sorry, I suffer with OCD. I want to make sure I remember to sell these items. I'll try not to sell my fishing bait. Where the hell did that go? Put that down there for now. I need to go to the golden saucer with that. It's already used. Tombry card? Yes, I already got one. So these need selling. What is this? Antidote. Yeah. Potions are so useless in this game, in my opinion. I've never had to use any, I've never seen anyone use any for that matter. So yeah, I'd also just go to the shop. Hello, Jivar. Well, if it isn't Selfie, Looking for some high Sutan, mayhap? Hmm? Here to retrieve an order for Mistress Tataru, you say? You come at a good time. I finished it but moments ago. It was no small coup working it to her specifications, but I did it nonetheless. Payment has already been settled. However, did that girl come by chemical hide any... I still can't... I can't talk properly today again. I apologise, I just can't talk properly. I'll be honest, I didn't really get a good night's sleep last night either. So, yeah, kind of tired through that. Yeah, it's kind of a lame excuse. But anyway, you need either balls of steel or a bottomless coin purse, and it seemed to me she had neither. Okay, Conjurer's Guild. Which door? This one. I always get confused with which doors to use. So I end up just walking into one, wondering why it's not moving. Like, opening. Conjurer's. I mean, yeah, so feel free to join our FC if you're on my server. But then again, I haven't said that. It's not my FC. So yeah, I'm not really sure if it's open to everybody. So yeah. Could always just ask. Because it might just be a private one, I'm not really sure. They only made it yesterday, last night. Anyway, greetings, Selfie. I trust you have been well. Is there art you require of me? Ah, yes, Mistress Tataru's order. As requested, it has been sanctified in the sight of the elementals. I know what she intends for the staff, but it is a most singular artifact. Even one possessed of my experience would struggle to wield it. Caroline Canopy? Is that near the inn? I think it is. Yes, it's near the inn. Where we first spoke to her. I still love Gridania. It's one of the best places in this game, in my opinion. You know, past the Aetherite here. Main one. I don't know, like, when I first started playing this game, like, 2 years ago, I just fell in love with the place. I like the music. Everything in it. But I like the other locations as well. I mean, Alder's alright, it's a bit too... Not to sound racist, but brown, if you know what I mean. For my taste, but it's fine. And Limbs is cool as well, I like the sea, so I'm a fan of that. It's probably like Gridania, then Limbs, then Alder for me. Madonna's pretty cool too though, but that's a bit dead now that we've got the new expansion. It used to be jam-packed with people, but they've all flown off to other locations. Ah, you're back. You have the items, I hope. Yep, I sure do. There you go. Ew, it's precisely as I requested. A perfect match for the other pieces. Truly, Chiva is a master among masters. And the staff completes the surprise. Thank you so much, Selfie. I can't wait to see what your stoler thinks of the surprise. Lest you wonder, she's doing very well, and the conjurers have left her in her sister's care. Let's go and pay them a visit, shall we? Cutscene time! Really? Battery's getting low already. Her face.
You stole her! I'm so glad you're back!
Tataru. You are safe, thank the 12. Something has changed about you, Elfino. Or mayhap the change is with me. I seem to sense the ether around me more keenly than before.
I am pleased to see you well again. Do you feel strong enough to talk?
Worry not. I am well enough.
Tell us then, what befell you after you fled the feast? We were told that there had been a tunnel collapse.
That was my doing. I brought the tunnel down that you and Minfidia might escape. At the last moment, I invoked a teleportation magic, in hopes of spiriting Thancred away at least. Needless to say, it did not go quite as planned, and I found myself adrift in the life stream. The others? Where are they? Did they not escape?
They remain unaccounted for. You were the only one we have been able to find. I am truly sorry. It was the Crystal Braves who pursued you that day. My hubris that led to our undoing.
No apologies are necessary, Alpha No. You are not to blame for what occurred. Know that were our comrades here, they would commend you for keeping the light of hope alive.
Don't worry. The others are alive and well, I'm sure of it. We just need to find them.
Indeed, Tataru. Let us find our friends and rebuild the Scions.
Ha! There is the Alphino I remember. And I feel much the better for his return. 'Tis time I arose.
Reminds me! I have a change of clothes for you! I don't like to boast, but I made them myself. I learned how to weave while we're in Ishgard, you see?
Tataru has apprised me of all that took place in the aftermath of the assassination plot. It would seem I have been away for some while.
Yes, much and more happened during your absence. At present, we seek to follow the Archbishop to Azislar.
And you want for some manner of etheric ram to pierce the floating isle's protective barrier?
We do. Might you be able to furnish us with one?
A means to prise open a hole in an Alagaan barrier. And one large enough to admit an airship, no less. Nay, I lack the knowledge to devise such a weapon. But I know of one who could. A leading figure in the field of etheric research, and one of the finest scholars ever to grace Sharlion. Matoya, my former master.
Matoya, huh? Miss Sears, wow, she's got some really nice clothes now. Tatru created his clothes and her clothes. Gotta say, she's quite what's the word I'm looking for here? Clothes designer, is that it? But yeah. Digging it. Onward to Sharlion. Ystola wishes to tell you more about her former master, Matoya. Yes, I know, controller. Stop reminding me. Gotta get round to charging it. But remember, in my youth. Oh my god. Okay, I get it, controller. I get it. Okay, I'll do it now. Alright, controller? Okay, so so yeah, I've got my controller now charged up, but yeah, it's the only wire I could find to charge my controller up was this really, really tiny minuscule wire. So like I have to sit on the floor. So like yeah, that was the sound of me like hitting the record button and getting off my chair, my lovely comfortable chair to sit on a floor. Yeah. Cause it doesn't reach to the chair. Unfortunately. It's so tiny, this cable. I think my other cables have kind of broke. So it's the only one I've got. And I've just noticed too, it's got some teeth marks on it. I wonder who the culprit of that is. Looking at you kiddies. Anyway, enough of that. Okay. In my youth, I had the honor of studying under Matoya. In the field of etheric research, she was without rival. I have no doubt that her knowledge will be of aid to our cause. The question is, will she share it with us? My master has ever been willful. The gods forbid anyone disagrees with her. When the Galleon Empire first marched upon Eorzea some 15 years ago, the denizens of Sharlion were summoned back to the motherland. However, Matoya refused to join the exodus. To this day, she lives a hermit's life on the fringes of the abandoned city. So it is to the Dravanian hinterlands that we must go. To the place of my birth. The Alisar and I were born in Sharlion. Our days there were short. We remained only until the Exodus, and I have not returned since. Oh, so it is to be a homecoming then? As fine a reason as any to go to Sharlion, and it would afford us the opportunity to pay my master a visit. Ahem. I believe you have mistaken our primary objective, Ystola. At any rate, the journey will take us through largely unknown territory. Let us first return to Ishgard and make our preparations. Okay, Ishgard it is. Foundation, I think that was Ishgard, wasn't it? It's been a while since I've been in Ishgard. But I think it's Foundation. Yeah, the Holy See of Ishgard. Around here? Ah, there we go. Posse is right here. Hello, Elfenau. Shalion is situated in Redvanian hinterlands. To get there, we must strike west and traverse to the breadth of Dravanian forelands. Make no mistake, it will be a grueling journey. The party shall be compromised. The party shall be comprised of Selfie, Ystola, and myself. Tataru, pray remain in Ishgard and continue the search for our missing friend. Yes, sir! First, let us make for Tailfeather. Roger that. How do I get there again? Oh, there it is. Right at the bottom. Sorry. Four locations. Boom, boom, boom. I don't really need a mount because it's not that far, but whatever. a long soak and a live stream followed by a long journey. I would not recommend it to anyone. But rest assured, my strength is returning to me. I shall be back to my former self ere long. A great new nation. What do we get? Only got one option. Ystola is ready to press on westward to the Dravanian hinterlands. I believe I am sufficiently rested. Let us continue west to Shalion. Once we descend the mountain path, we will arrive at the Dravanian hinterlands. From there, it is but a short distance to the city. Be warned that we shall be passing through Nath territory. We must needs be wary of them and the dragons both. Where? Am I blind? Where are we going? I see no marker. Okay. Okay. So it's not in this location. We're going to a new one, by the looks of it. No, we can't go that way. There's only one exit and entry via that place, unfortunately. I don't know of anyone. Right, so really I'm still going the wrong way though. All the way around. Barely. I want to play with Sleaze right now. Or a Bandersnatch. This seems like it's miles away. You sure I can't just teleport to this place? Let's pause for a second. Joining area to what? Okay, okay, we've got no other choice. Reminds me, I still need to unlock the monk's newer abilities. I still haven't done that. Keep forgetting. Come on, you can make it. Get a level 60, hopefully do some get into some under sync whatever parties makes things much easier, and hopefully complete things that I've never completed before, like Twin Tanya, T5 of the Binding Coil. I know doing the coil now is completely useless, so everyone's just doing Alexander. But I wouldn't mind like completing it for the story, but I've been stuck on T5 for ages. I should like seek, well I should have tried to seek out a, was it a raid or something? No, not raid, like, just a group of people to do it with at specific times and stuff, yeah. But it never occurred to me, and now it's a bit too late. Because nobody's really doing anymore.
To the Thaliac River. Where to the melted snows of Abelathia's spine eventually find their way by means of 1,000 silver streams. Whose waters have long nourished the Trevanian hinterlands, and so provided for a settlement of learned souls from across the northern sea. To the city of Sharlion, that great seat of knowledge, now abandoned by her keepers, they came.
Matoya dwells on the far side of the Thaliac River. Let us search for a crossing. All these buildings look destroyed and like broken. But it looks like a nice place. Ooh, hello. El Poco Loco. Alright, it's mouth. Because why not? And we're under attack. Vulnerability up. Really? Why? I'm under a bit of vulnerability up. Okay, right. Why people have to go in this place? We're going there anyway. I'm gonna try and find a Ethernet, something like that. Reminds me, I still need to start collecting those things so I can start having flying mounts. Ticket, there's one in here.
I'm hunting for an Ethernet.
What do we want somewhere? Ooh, what's this? Part of the building. What about map? Does map indicate any? No. Am I going to the right place anyway? I again see no map. I'm going to go to the place anyway. Local, this nearby building. I would like to find an Ethernet, just in case we end up dying. Doubt I will, but who knows. I mean, I think I'm... Well, okay, maybe. Around the same level as the mob, so it's possible. An Ethernet in here? God damn, really? I think I'm still going to the right place. Where I need to be. First thing it said, the bridge ahead is collapsed. I'm afraid we shan't be crossing there. But worry not, I know another way. See you, the towering structure to the north? We should be able to cross there. But 15 years abandoned, and already Shalion has fallen into such disarray. Verily, a city is no more than its inhabitants. Yeah, I know, I thought it was going to be a nice place. It's got monsters everywhere. More like a hostile place. And I see no Ethernet. Map. The map sees no Ethernet neither. Let's just progress. Maybe we'll eventually come across one. Idleshire? Knowledge seeks no man. So says the motto of Charlian engraved upon yonder stone. The meaning is simple. It falls to us to seek enlightenment. During the 6th Astral Era, at the turn of the 18th century, men from the northern nation of Charlian journeyed across the seas to Eorzea in search of knowledge. Upon arriving at these shores, they established a camp for their scholarly endeavours. Over time, this camp grew into a settlement, and the settlement prospered, and so much so that it came to be counted amongst Eorzea's great city-states. Alas, those glory days are now but a fading memory. With her keepers lost to her, Charlian has become an empty husk of her former self. Pfft! Uplander is mistaken. Charlian has new keepers, is on cusp of new age of glory. Oh, hello, goblins. Goblins? Here to plunder the city? Uplander is mistaken, Muchly. We are not thieves. This place is our home. Your home? When last I looked, it was mine and Alphanar's. We were born here. When Uplanders abandoned city, Uplanders gave up claim. Born here or no, Uplanders are trespassers. My friends, please, we did not come to dispute your claim to this land. Our purpose here is peaceful. We desire but to cross the river. Be calm, I beg you, and let us speak like the civilized folk that we are. Surely we can come to a mutual understanding. If that is truth, then Uplanders are welcome here. Come with Slothfix. Slothfix will show Uplander's settlement. Slothfix. It's a very Slothfix. Woolnicks. Really. I love how they've come up with some weird and odd, strange names for these things. It's like, that one's kind of like, I don't know, I see his name, and like, it's like Woolly Knickers. What do you think? Woolly Knickers, Woolly Knicks? Or is that just me? Cheap chicks. Okay. Well, this place seems a lot more, like, it has a lot more... It's more popular. It's got people in it. Which I was kind of expecting with the other place, but I just had loads of mobs in instead. So surely, in that case... It'll have a Ethernet, right? Somewhere? Will my map show it? Ah, oh, there we go! I found one! Oh, let me have it. Oh my god, I actually walked past it to begin with. Oh, yes. Oh, wait a minute, I can't do it for me. Oh, that feels loads more better now. Really, it just feels so much better. Hello. Here is Heart of Settlement, name of Idleshire. What have we got here, guests? Greetings to you. I am an elf and our levelier, and may I introduce my companions, Selfie Tilmit and Eustola. We have journeyed far in search of a friend, and seek to cross the river. But finding the main bridge collapsed, you went looking for a detour and ended up stumbling into Slowfix and his crew. Is that right? That is the short of it, aye. This place, Idleshire, I came expecting a ghost town. Suffice it to say, I'm surprised to find it so alive. Well, with all them precious artifacts lying about, t'was only a matter of time afore treasure hunters like me moved in. But we weren't the first to arrive. Neither. By then, Slowfix and his gobby friends were already settled. At first, gobbies and hunters disliked each other. But understanding came, then friendship. Now gobbies and hunters have joined hands to build great new nation. So, that is what happened after we Shalians departed? Oh, so you're locals. No hard feelings, I hope. All these nice buildings, but no one to live in them. Felt like a waste, you know? We've been trying to put the place to rights, and things have been going well, for the most part. But it ain't all smooth sailing. Not to sound ungrateful, but the traps your people left lying about are a bloody nuisance. And there's the Illuminati harrying us day and night. Pfft. Slowfix has bright idea. Uplanders desire mutual understanding, yes? Best way to understanding is helping one another. Help citizens of Idleshire, and Uplanders can be citizens too. Citizens are free to cross river. Well, I am not aware of a quicker way to reach our destination. Let us assist Slowfix and his people. Well, we only had one option here. Because I do not play tank. Might in the future, but at the moment, no. DPS and healer. Golems be gone. Anything for me? Nope. Possibly. Nope. We either got intelligence materia or... I know what, I'll go for the intelligence materia. Slowfix wants you to eliminate the golems that prowl Idleshire. So Uplanders agreed to help? Good! Here is what Slowfix wants Uplanders to do. Many golems prowl Idleshire, get in the way of expansion plans. Slowfix wants Uplanders to eliminate golems. Uplanders are Shalian, yes? Shalian should know best way to deal with creatures. So we are to eliminate the golems. That should be a simple enough affair. The automata were employed as sentinels, and by design can be unmade with a coded command. At the time of the Exodus, it was naughts and crosses, and I see no reason why it should not still work. Let us divide the task between the three of us, the quicker to be finished with it. Is the chat mode and say use your keyboard or the software keyboard to enter the command noughts and crosses to unmake a golem. Okay. Considering it's quite a lot to type, bear with me a sec. I'm going to get my keyboard out. Sometimes I don't have my keyboard out. I just use the built-in one. But I think it would be a good idea to use it. Okay, so we also need this in the PlayStation. Sorry about that. We are now good to go. Okay, so hold on, we need a map. There we go, that's our first golem. Okay, what if we say noughts and crosses? Take it with the... Because my cats have had a good go at this keyboard. The shift buttons. A bit faulty, so... Okay, right. I'm so organized. And that right. Do something. Have we spelled this right? Oh, for fuck's sake, really. And O, not A. Now it should work. With an A. If we don't put the A in. I cannot spell. Right. There we go! Yes, got it in the end. And down you go. With a shudder, the golem crumbles to pieces. It sure does. And it also disappears. Appears into the void. Right, we've gone the wrong way. Next one is up here. In fact, I can see it. Knots and crosses. Too far away. Typical. And that good? Good. Timber. And back to the goblin, I guess. Slow fix. Yo, suffix. Golems are no more! Wonderful! Now we can resume work to expand settlement. Alright, I was gonna go for the materials.